In this video I will show you how to make the weapon belts, quiver and pouch. First I'm going to make the belt that's going over the right shoulder. And for that I have a strap of leather that's 5 cm or about 2.5 inch wide. Lay the strap over your right shoulder and measure out how much you need and take some extra length and then trim it off. I got a buckle with 2 pins that will fit the strap of leather. And first I measure out the locations where the pins will go through the leather and cut some holes. And then fold the strap of leather around the buckle and make some holes for rivets to secure it later on. And on the other side of the belt I made some holes where the pins can hook into. Next I got a smaller belt that's 2.5 cm or about 1 inch wide and fold it around the wide belt and punch the hole for a rivet later on. The small belt is going over your left shoulder and will connect to the wide belt on your back. So I measured out how much length I need and then trimmed it off. And then punched a hole in the other end. Now lay the 2 belts to the side for a while so you can work on the waist belt. For the waist belt I used the same small strap of leather. First cut off 2 pieces that are about 25 centimeters or 10 inch long. And then round off the corners of one side of each piece. Then I got 2 long buckles and got rid of the pins and I fold the ends of the strap of leather that are not rounded off over the buckle and punch some holes and temporarily secure the pieces with split pins. Now get another piece of small leather strap and pull it through one of the buckles and punch the hole and secure it with a split pin as well. And then pull the other end of the strap through the other buckle. And then hold the belt around your waist and determine the length you need by adjusting the belt. Remember that this belt is not going all around your waist. The end should stop at about the side of your belly. Once you determine the correct length, you can trim it off and just like the other side you can punch a hole and temporarily secure it with a split pin. Next I punch 2 holes in the leather at the middle of each buckle. Then I cut 2 straps that are about 12 centimeters or 4.7 inch long. Punch a hole in each end of the straps and just like before secure them to the buckles with split pins. Then lay the belt flat on the table and measure out another strap that will connect the 2 smaller pieces together. Just like all the other joints we will punch 2 holes and secure those with split pins as well. Next I cut 4 smaller pieces of leather and 2 of those will connect the waist belt in the middle and 2 of them will connect to the shoulder belts. You don't have to punch holes this time as we will sew those pieces together. Lay everything to the side again and next I use some templates and some scrap pieces of leather to make the shapes of the pouch. I also made 2 rectangle pieces of leather that will be attached to the back of the pouch so you can slide it over the waist belt later on. For the quiver I will use a 60 mm PVC pipe. I cut off a piece that's 55 centimeters long or about 21.5 inch. Next I place the pipe on a piece of leather, draw the circle and cut it out. I also cut out 2 pieces of leather that will be wrapped around the pipe. Those 2 pieces will be attached to the smaller belt that's going over your left shoulder. So I measured out the spots where I want those pieces to be connected to the belt and punched some holes. And also cut holes in the ends of the pieces so they can be attached with a lace later on. Next get all your pieces of leather back and remove all the temporarily split pins. And then I use some leather dye to make all the pieces brown. While the dye is drying I cut out a piece of thin leather that will fit around the PVC pipe. Note that this piece of leather should be about 10 centimeters or 4 inch longer than the pipe itself. I also cut out some fringes and made white patterns on 2 red pieces of fabric. I will sew the sides of the leather together and add a fringe on every stitch I did. And also add the red pieces of fabric at the bottom and about halfway down. After I sew those sides together, the circle piece of leather that we made earlier has been dried, so I could sew it to the bottom. After everything is sewn together, you kind of have a sleeve for your PVC pipe. Now get that PVC pipe back and pull the leather over it. This sleeve is tight, so it might take you some effort to get it over the pipe. After the sleeve is in place, I use some spray glue and spray it in the end and fold it inside the pipe. Then I used a small leather lace and stitched it near to the top of the quiver. Now lay the quiver to the side for a while and start sewing the pieces of the pouch together. I sew two small straps and buckles to the pouch so I can close it up. After that, get the white shoulder belt and fold it around the buckle and secure it with rivets. Then get the small shoulder belt and fold it around the white belt and secure it with rivets as well. Then get the small piece of leather that will hold the quiver to the belts and rivet those in place. Then get all the pieces for the waist belt and assemble it together using more rivets. The two smaller belts that will hold the parallel belts together will be folded around and sewn together. Using my Dremel and a sanding stone, I made a cut in each end of the waist belt. Next, get the pouch and the two rectangle pieces of leather and rivet it onto the pouch with the waist belt underneath. Now it's time to attach the waist and shoulder belt together. So I use the last two smaller pieces of leather and fold them around the belts and sew them together. Next, I cut a long strip of leather and leave the collar as it is, and then wrap it around the white belt near to the location where your shoulder will be. I made some stitches at the end to prevent it from unwrapping. Finally, you can attach the quiver to the belt. So wrap the quiver attachment around the quiver. I use a small string of leather and pull it through the holes, and then stitch the ends together. To finish it off, I went outside and found two white feathers and used a blue marker to make the tip of the feathers blue. Then I used some string to attach the feathers to the quiver. After that, everything is done. This was my weapon belt, quiver, and pouch tutorial. Thanks for watching.